right, we're back for the first time in 9 months. I know what you're thinking. And yes, I did have a baby. It was a girl. And then, the economy is going in the toilet. Nothing a bald, unlicensed plumber with unpaid back taxes can't fix. And my guest is RJ Umberger of the Columbus Blue Jackets. They're a hockey team. They play down the street. The Blue Jackets. Shield your eyes. You don't want to look directly into this supernova of truth. This is the Campus Report. Thank you, thank you. No, no, you, sir. You look good. Welcome to the report, everybody. Campus, it's good to be back. We've been in reruns since the spring of last year, and seeing as how we only did 5 episodes and they air twice a day, I'm guessing you've all seen them 123 times by now. I'm sure you're interested in why I've been away for so long. No, I wasn't really pregnant. That's just a rumor. I don't really know where that got started. I actually left Ohio State to pursue a career in modeling. I was told this shack in Charleston, West Virginia was the place to go to really break into the modeling world. Turns out it was actually an international porn ring. The guy kept me locked in a dungeon. It was horrible. Before we get to the real issues of the day, I need to talk about something no one cares about. The Lantern. Campus, if you've seen the show before, you know of my burning hatred for the Lantern. And in case you haven't, I made a little video to fully express my burning hatred for the Lantern. Oh, the Lantern, with your first copy free, additional copies, 50 cents crap. Look at how many copies I took. Didn't pay a cent for them. Oh, whoops, dropped that one. Good thing I have 30 other ones. Who the hell works for these people? Now, before you call me a hypocrite, it's all a plan. I'm going to slowly destroy them from the inside by slyly sabotaging their online edition. Check out this edit I slipped through. It's only a matter of time. Now, to try to bring peace between a titan of mass media and the Lantern is difficult, but being the guy I am, I thought I'd take the first step. So I invited Lantern advisor and ex-Cleveland Plain Dealer overlord Tom O'Hara to come on my show. I know, mighty big of me. Well, Campus, it's been weeks, and not only has he not said yes, he hasn't even replied to me. The courteous thing to do when you know you're going to be beaten down in an interview is to politely decline. In all fairness, he's a newspaper man, and maybe he doesn't know how to work the internets or the magical keyboard etch-a-sketch on his desk. Oh, the newspapers are dying. An historic time of the year, no doubt. Barack Obama sworn in as the 44th president of the United States, first African-American president, and CNN covered the inauguration down to the last disgusting detail. Even Fox News tried to find something nice to say about our new Democratic president.
And you can see that with Barack and Michelle as well. They do a lot of touching, kissing, even fisting.
Now I can only assume this woman means the fist bump. But this just shows why older, uncool people should not try to talk about parts of youth culture. Campus, the American economy has just been falling apart without me. I believe an epidemic of cannibalism has broken out in the Western United States. They've changed the official CNN logo from this to this. But if you've watched any newscast this year, you've had enough of all the gloom and doom, the warnings of the collapse of capitalism, analyst after analyst telling you why you should convert all your US money into Disney dollars. So instead of hammering you with clever similes about how the US economy is plummeting into the bowels of poverty like a drunken muskrat with no marketable skills, we're going to provide you with some positive spin on the issue. And for a look at that, we turn to our economic expert, Ben Fox.
Thanks, Donnie.
Now, so Ben, where is this abyss gonna bottom out?
I don't know.
Would you care to elaborate on that? Something positive, perhaps?
Not really.
I thought you were a market expert.
This is a crisis as all the experts baffled, Donnie.
Isn't there something good you can tell the terrified people out there?
Let's see, okay, no matter how bad things are here in America, we can take solace in the fact that at least we're not Zimbabwe. The country has suffered from uncontrollable inflation that has reached 6.5 quadrillion novacamadiclinian percent.
I didn't even know percentages went up that high.
Me either. That's 65 followed by 107 zeros.
That's a lot of numbers.
Apparently, they had to introduce a new percentage in the world of mathematics solely for the country of Zimbabwe. Their government recently had to issue the 100 billion note due to the countrywide cash shortage.
A $100 billion note? That doesn't sound like a bad thing.
Well, 100 billion Zimbabwe dollars are worth $1.25 in the United States. You can barely purchase a loaf of bread with it.
Wow, that is quite worthless.
Indeed. In fact, no one in the country even accepts a Zimbabwe dollar anymore. Oh wait, 50 billion is now worth $1.13.
So basically they're wasting money by printing money.
But remember, the money they're wasting is also worthless. $1.06.
Now hold on, I'm being told that we have senior Southeastern African correspondent Tyler Mitchell live in JFK Airport. Tyler?
What's happening, Donnie?
Tyler, you're just arriving back from Zimbabwe, is that correct?
Oh yeah, just waiting here in JFK.
Where did you get all that stuff?
Donnie, one word, Sky Mall Magazine. This trip to Zimbabwe was very profitable for Tyler Mitchell.
How so?
I convinced a local merchant to trade me $1 trillion for everything I had in my bank account.
How much was that?
Only like $15,000. What a sucker.
You traded $15,000 for $1 trillion Zimbabwe dollars?
That's what we savvy investors refer to as ripping off the bitch.
If you traded away all your money, how'd you afford all that stuff?
Donnie, haven't you ever been rich? I bought it all on credit. Once my cash gets through customs, I'll pay for it in full, you know, if I feel like it.
There's something you should probably know. $1 trillion Zimbabwe dollars is only worth about 25 bucks.
What?
The exchange rate, uncontrollable inflation.
But the American dollar value has been plummeting.
I know, but Tyler, are you crying?
No, it's fine.
Tyler Mitchell, everybody.
Wow, that guy's screwed.
Indeed. We'll be right back.
Hey, Visa. It looks like someone stole my credit card. Yeah, there's all these charges to SkyMall.